Hello everyone, my name is John Miling Sondra. Today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today my subject will be seascape. So it will be a beach, and I'm going to make it a stormy weather, and I'm going to put there some palm trees that been hit by a great wind. Okay, it will be like a sunset or something like a moonrise or moonset, and I'm going to put a boat here. Okay. So yeah, that will be my plan, and I hope that this one will turn out good. Okay, please don't forget to subscribe. If you subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications on my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see the 5 different colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and we have here the sketch, and we're gonna do now the underpainting. So I'm gonna make the sky gray, everyone. Even the water is gray. It'll be like maybe after the storm, after the typhoon, or maybe typhoon is coming and the wind blows, something like that. Okay. So I'm going to start. By mixing purple. I have something here, really is purple. I think my palette is so watery. Okay, it's a lot of water. So all I have to do, everyone, the basic is to paint it over, okay, put the underpainting. I'm gonna put brown or umber. We can add a little bit of white to make it lighter. So I think my paints are so fluid, okay? I think there's so much water. Okay. So I have to put more. Okay, so here. So it's raining, everyone. Everyone, so I stopped a little bit because it was raining. Yeah, that's good that my paint is a little bit dry now. A little umber, and then the purple, and then you can put some white. So I just tried to add the underpainting. I am doing the underpainting first, so it's pretty normal to look like this. So I ask you to do also like this. Before starting the painting. Blue and the red. You can add the umber. Because I'm not using any black, everyone, that's why I just use the blue and the red. Actually, it's look like black. And then I'll try to retouch the sky. Blue and the red and then white. Little umber. I will use a smaller brush. Well, this is the medium size flat brush. This is number 8, and then we can add more. I think add more a little bit of orange there on this part. So you have here the yellow and then the red. You can add more red like that and then white. More white. And then we can use more red and then white. Here we can add more orange, say in this part here. There, and then we will try more reddish purple, more red, and then blue and then white, everyone. Yeah, okay. Okay. Okay, so you know something like a purple sky. You can also add a bit of blue to make it dark. There. You can put some amber to make it grayish and then white. Okay, there you go. Yeah, so we have now a little bit of yellow sky there. Yeah, I like that. Or something orange sky. So I'm gonna mix again for purples. I'm gonna put some amber and then white. I'll try to put it here on the bottom part. I think that's too much dark. There. There. Yellow and then red. And then white. Make this bottom a little bit orange. Okay.
Yeah, maybe I'm going to try to make it like a moonrise, everyone. So I'm gonna try to add some white here. And then I have here the blue and the red to make some, yeah, purple and then white. We can try to add some lights here. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Okay, so I like the sky, everyone. It's dark. I just want to make it dark now. And then you can use some orange to retouch some parts right here. Okay. We add a little bit of yellow and then white. Sometimes everyone can see a yellowish moonrise. I observe it. Okay. Yeah, that looks good. So simple and looking good. Okay, everyone, here I'm gonna put the, yeah, wait. Still need to use some reddish purple. Okay. I didn't hear everyone. I have to try to put more yellowish here, something like that, and white. Make it that there's a waves there. It'll be very wavy and windy. Okay, so we can try this color. It's a light amber. Okay, I mean light reddish yellow. No, reddish purple, I mean, sorry. And then I'll try to add more purple here. So I'm gonna use this brush, everyone. I'm gonna thicken the paints there. I'm gonna use this biggest brush. So I'll just use the reddish purple and the white. Okay, I need more. Maybe I'll just use the purple. Yeah. There. I need to put some more red. And then yellow. No, I mean red, okay. It's purple, everyone, and then I'm gonna put through amber. Blue and the red, and then through amber, and then white. Because I'm gonna put cannot see so much good because of the glare from the other. I need to change my what do you call this lights, everyone, because I cannot see good. So will be a mountain here. Okay. Here, everyone, this is another island, and this one is an island also. I'm going to try to put some small trees here. So yeah, I'm gonna use this. Looks like that the tree, everyone, is also hit by what do you call this, hit by a great wind. Okay. There, so that mountain there will be very just misty mountain, or I think a little bit gray, yes. So it doesn't, you cannot see it so good. Okay, so I will try to draw here the boat. So I'm gonna use this romper. The boat, everyone, will be huge and yeah, it will be like this. They are, I think, in the very bad situation, everyone. The boat is in very bad situation. Yeah. Okay, so something like that. I'll just put some raw umber. I'll just put raw umber on the boat, the under painting. Or maybe I'll put here the blue on the raw umber and the red, and then some white to make it not so much bright. And then I'm gonna try to use a little bit raw umber and then white and then some yellow. Well, maybe a little bit purple, everyone. I'll try to change the color. Blue, red, and then white. Okay, and then we can try to put some highlights also. Can use this white and then yellow. Okay, and then you can put a little bit of orange, especially here on the side of the boat. There. Okay. I'll use a smaller brush, this one around. I'm gonna use this a little bit darker color. I think this brush is not so fine, so big. Okay, so yeah, it just look like a very old boat. It's gonna have a wreckage. So here, everyone on the top, I will put it later. But here, I'm planning to add some palm trees on the top of the, of this mountain or in this big rock. Okay, so this I'm going to start now adding some waves here. Splashing here, something like that. So I'm gonna use this reddish purple. Purple, but put more red. It's gonna be a very big wave, everyone. Yeah, okay. Blue and then red. And then white. Okay, so I can put more details. I can put a little bit blue if you want to make some dark also. And also put the umber, a bit of blue. And then you can add more white. And put it on the top. There. Okay. So I am just playing with this, everyone. Having this one here, we need to put more waves. Yeah. So the water, everyone, looks so angry, and yeah. I'm going to use a smaller brush now. This one. I'm gonna use this yellow with the red, and then a lot of white. So there are also waves here hitting this part. And then on the back also. There. Did you hear everyone? There's a wave hitting on this rocky world, a rocky mountain, or rocky cliff. Living here. Just to like that everyone and follow the strokes that I'm doing. There. So as you can see, the waves are really looking angry, everyone, like there's really a big typhoon going on there, okay? So I'm gonna try to refine some parts. There. And then I will try to use a little bit more reddish purple. Okay, darker. This one is darker. And then I will try to add a little bit of transparency in green, everyone. Blue green, something like that. Blue and then yellow. Then white. a little bit of bluish or blue green, something like that, so that the water will become more like really transparent. There. Yeah, the water becoming really looking good. It looks bluish, and you can see underneath. Look like really water. And you can see that everyone, the waves are really looking angry. Okay. I'm gonna try to put more blue to make it much more bluish. Can put it here. Even here, a little bit bluish, and then we can use the bluish purple and then white. Okay, so this one will be a rock here. And then you can use this light orange. Also here, this one. Okay. Yeah. I think that looks so good, everyone. It looks so angry. The water looks so angry. Yeah. And I like it. I like how it turns out. Yeah, this is what I also imagine. Now this one, we can put a little bit transparency on this what do you call this? Is sail, okay, something like that. So we can use the yellow, red, and then umber. More red, everyone. try to look like transparent. And also this one here. There, okay. And then we can add some highlights. Yeah, it looks like a boat now, like a yacht. Okay, there you go. That is very good. Like how simple this one, everyone. It looks simple, those waves and everything there. Looks very, very simple. I'm going to add also some splashing, or here, some foam here, white foam, something like that. But do not make it too light, so maybe just white here, just mix it with the purple, and then you can put it here. Can also put a lot of white foams here. There. Okay, so that looks like some white foams. Yeah. So I like the light around hitting on a certain part. It makes it look good. Okay. It makes us focus on a certain part, which hit by the light. And I like this, I like the effect. Okay. So this one would be rock here. I'll be using the medium size flat brush. And here's the raw umber, the blue and the red. We can also hear everyone. You can spread a little bit of foams here. Yeah, so blue and then blue umber and then white. Okay. You can add a little bit of mist. Okay, so as you can see, yeah, it's misty here in the spot. And then I will try to use this brush, everyone. I'm gonna try to use a clean, pure white. So yeah, we can add a bit more foams here. Okay, so look like that it's really heat on the rock, on the foam, or yeah, the foam looks good. I like it. Look like that it's glowing even here, right? I'm going to enhance the color here. Yeah. there, as you can see, that it only hit on that part. Those lights, okay, coming from the sun, or coming from the moon. Yeah, it looks like a sunrise, but this looks like a sunrise for me. But it's fine. Yeah. Okay, this just looks so good. It looks so good. I like it, and it's just not so much. It doesn't take so much of your time also, because this is just, I think, 1 hour. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to try to put more, I think, here. I just use the raw umber. So I'm gonna use I'm using the small flat brush of mine. A little bit brownish here. I'm adding a little bit of brownish around so that you can also see some brownish here. Because sometimes the sun will mix it with the waves and it will turn brownish. There, okay. Yeah. Maybe we can put more foams. Usually, everyone, it has a lot of foams. Like that. Multiple foams in the water. Okay, so yeah. I don't want this one. I will just make it dark, everyone, so it's fine. Okay, so final task, everyone. I'll just put some palm tree there on the top. So red. And then blue, and then amber. Yeah, because of the strong waves, everyone. Okay. I'll use this brush, this small size flat brush. Okay. Yeah. So I think that's very strong wing. That even this palm tree everyone. He cannot hold on to it. So not just the palm tree, but I can put some trees also. So just tapping technique. Okay, yeah, so I don't want to put any lights, everyone. I don't want to put anything there, just a little bit dark there, so that it will becoming it will becoming easier for you to paint also. No, not so much details, just pure colors, forms, a little bit of forms, and then movements to make it look windy. So yeah, it will be a very different effect. And I think this is my first time painting like this, like a stormy weather, like there's a very huge wind there, and you can feel that it's a very dangerous wind, and it's maybe typhoon, something like that.
Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.